know, Lockhart, I've been thinking, we don't talk often enough. It's so hard to talk to you when you guys are so far away. Do you know what else is really hard because you're so far away? Kingdom Arts and Sciences competitions. And that's what I want to talk to you about in this video. How we're bringing in some changes that will help with the huge kingdom that is Lockhart. It's one of the largest kingdoms in the known world. Kingdom comps as they are currently designed aren't working for Lockhart. All the conversations I've had on competitions and the responses to the Kingdom-wide Arts and Sciences survey indicate that most of our population finds them confusing, closed, not accessible, and uninspiring. It's why we get 3 to 15 entries per competition, which is a really tiny segment of our user base. And the problem with it is that Kingdom competitions rely on you being present at an event that has a competition that you are interested in where you have already made a thing. And there's a very, very, very small segment of people for whom that overlap works. So we did a survey 18 months ago about arts and sciences in Lockhart, and one of the largest, most overwhelming areas of improvement that came through were Kingdom Arts and Sciences competitions. And I just want to read out for you some of the things that were said in this survey. So these are voices of actual people from Lockhart who responded to the survey. They said, it's too hard to enter from the West Coast. They're currently designed to discourage entries. Poorly entered, but getting to the events can be difficult. Far too much documentation. Good, but can be scary or inaccessible for those living in a different country with no access to Kingdom events. Many competitions look appealing to members, but are just too far away. Poorly designed for this Kingdom's geographical size. Too far away to be entered into. A bit pointless given how big Lockhart is and the realities of the cost of travel and postage and how varied the spread of resources are. Some areas are Laurel and Arts and Sciences heavy, while others have very little. Complicated. A great way to showcase examples, but perhaps needs to be more accessible. Intimidating for people to enter. They already think their work and documentation needs to be Laurel standard for local competitions and really bulk at Lockhart level. I think the problem is that they focus on individual effort. If the competitions encouraged group efforts, we could start to see some of the passion and rivalry we see in martial competition. In need of rejuvenation. So as you can hear, out of 236 entries, those are just some of the responses that came through, and it was pretty overwhelming. The question as to why, whether you would enter a Kingdom competition was surprising. The majority of people said they would enter a competition, and when we asked why or why they wouldn't enter, the answers were resoundingly that they would enter for feedback. People want feedback. They want to know that what they're doing is good and interesting, and more importantly, how they can improve. People would enter because of new stuff, a new skill, a new area to try. It gave creative tension and an opportunity to be inspired by something new. And last but not least, they would enter, or they think other people should enter, because it should increase the renown of artisans to enter and be ranked in a Kingdom Arts and Sciences competition. Now, at the moment, we're not doing those things well enough. So we have problems. We have problems that our competitions are uninspiring, they're confusing, they're intimidating, and people can't get their stuff to them in order to be judged so they can understand how they can improve. This is what we want to change, and here's how we're going to do it. Uninspiring. We've already fixed that. The topics have been improved to be wide-ranging and in line with what people of Lockhart actually work on. We've had 14th century as a competition category, Norse as a competition category, and we got a decent amount of entries in each of those categories, which was very different to what was happening beforehand. We will keep doing that. Confusing. They're confusing because the rubric is confusing. So a rubric is how we decide how many points an item gets. And that rubric that we've been working with for the last 15 years, hardly anyone understands it, and it doesn't make sense. I've judged competitions and I find it hard to understand. So we're gonna use a better one. And Yala has a rubric that they've been using for a long time. Everyone I know who's used that rubric says that it's good, says that it makes sense, and I've had new judges say it's the one time that they understood what it was they were supposed to be doing as a judge. And what that tells me is that people that get judged under that system will also be able to read it and understand what it is they can do to improve, how to make their entries better, but more importantly, because it's not about entries, it's about how they can make their stuff better and how they can make what they work on better and how they can make their skills better, because that is what a competition is actually about. It's not about winning. No one said winning. Three people out of 236 people said that winning was important to them. If you want to improve, if we want to give people guidance on how to improve, that rubric has to be better. Intimidating. So here's how we fix intimidating. Instead of being in a pool of people related to a topic, and then the winner being the person who's best in the topic, which is always going to be the person who's probably had the most experience, let's be honest, why don't we choose winners, winners, inverted commas, based on the actual experience level of the person entering? So, this is what's going to happen. We will have winners in the following categories: beginner, intermediate, experienced, and a group entry, which is really exciting. So, that means that someone who's been practicing a skill for less than 3 years is compared to other people who have been practicing a skill, possibly a different skill, for less than 3 years. So if I wanted to enter something that I'd made at a class by Alex the Potter, and I've done 6 months of pottery ever in my life, I would be in the beginner category, because that's, it's about the amount of time you spent on that skill, not the amount of time that you've been in the society or the amount of time you've been practicing any skill. If we had someone from a mundane world who came and joined us, and perhaps they'd been weaving for the last 10 years, they might choose to enter experience because they've got a lot of experience, but not necessarily in our society. And as for group entries, well, we all remember the Politicopolis pentathlon and how inspiring that was and how much energy there was around that. There's no reason we can't have group entries in Kingdom Arts and Sciences competitions, so let's just do it. Last but really not least, and this is the major change, is accessibility. We need to be able to ensure that anyone across LOCARC can enter any topic that they are interested in that's set as a Kingdom competition topic. So, here's how we're going to do that. That rubric that I spoke about earlier, that's the calibration for arts and sciences. Our heavy fighters have a calibration system, our fencers have a calibration system, and we've always had a calibration system. It's the rubric. That means that any item can be judged anywhere in the kingdom by anyone as long as it follows that rubric. And we can train people and we can give guidance about that, but it means that there's no barrier to being judged anywhere. So, in future, from kingdom event to kingdom event, there will be 3 topics open. Those topics can be judged at any official SCA event as long as the Arts and Sciences Officer is present and willing to do the paperwork. That's the barrier. What does that mean? That means tomorrow, for instance, when I'm going to the Rowanie bunch of classes, if the local Arts and Sciences Officer, Lady Annabelle de Swinburne, wanted to host some time for Kingdom competitions to be dealt with, we've got archery coming up, for instance, I could take an item that fit with the archery topic to that event, have it judged, the points would be sent to a central database, and then at Rowanie Festival this year, which is May Crown this year, points would all be tallied together and the winner would be decided from across the kingdom. It's a much better system. It's like what the Cooks Guild do at the moment. It's like what ICAC does at the moment. There's no reason we can't do it in arts and sciences. So what does this mean? It means better cross-kingdom visibility for our artisans. It means that if a group is really into competitions or into a particular topic, they could muster together to enter that competition, not relying on a kingdom event being held in their local group. Let me make this clear, not every group has to do this. If it fits your group culture, do it. No one's going to make you have kingdom competitions at local events. This is up to you and your Arts and Sciences Officer. It also means we can start talking about personal best. Because there are points, they're out of 50. If you go through one competition and you get 15 points, you might want to improve. Maybe the next one you get to 22. So you start competing with yourself for your own improvement, not with the kingdom and not by some random topics that you happen to enter in that particular time. And last but not least, I can see a role for guilds in this. So if a topic relates to a guild, I'll use the Weavers Fibre Guild again. Woven is a topic for 12th Night 2019. That guild could muster its members together and say, let's make an effort so that we've got a competition and you can enter at your local events for Woven, which means the Fibre Guild can use that as a way of increasing profile and activity. That's it. Those are the changes. They're reasonably substantial, but they're not scary. They're not massively, there's not a massive change compared to what we've been doing. It's just rejigging it a little bit. We've developed some stuff to help, because you can't create change like this without help. So there are pages on the Kingdom Arts and Sciences website that clearly set out what these rules are, how and how they are applied. There are pages that talk about how to enter a kingdom competition, how to judge a kingdom competition, including how to give feedback, and more importantly, how to set up a kingdom competition at an event, and all of the forms and documentation that you need to do that. We even have a page on how to write good documentation, because that was came through as a really big area that people were really scared about. That page is now there, and if you wanted to enter as a group, if you wanted to create an item and then ask a friend to help you with documentation, that's a legitimate group entry. So I really, 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 really hope that you get inspired and excited by these changes, and if you have any questions, then just contact me. I'm Clara Vandermeis. You can find me on Facebook. You can find me through the Kingdom Minister email address, and I'm really happy to talk at Rowanie Festival or any event that I go to.